بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، we continue our discussion regarding the beautiful and majestic names of our Creator. And of the names that are mentioned in the Quran is the name Al-Wadud. The name Al-Wadud. And the name Al-Wadud, it comes from the verb Wadda. And the verb Wadda means to love. But it is not just any type of love. All of us, we know the main word for love in Arabic is what? Mahabba and Hub. But Al-Wadud is not from this verb, Habba, Yuhibbu. It is from another verb, Wadda. So of the names of Allah is a name that deals with love, but it is not the primary verb for love. It is another verb. So what is the difference between Mahabba and Wud? What is the difference between the primary verb of love in Arabic, which is mahabba, and this verb that Allah uses to derive His name from? Our scholars have mentioned that the Arabic word hub or mahabba can be used for any type of love. It is the most generic verb for love. But wud is a specific subset of love. Wud is a special type of love. And of the specialities of wud is that when you have this type of love, you want to benefit the person whom you have this wood for. As well, it is a nurturing love. And that is why it's very common to have this verb to describe the love that a mother has for her child. It's a nurturing love. As well, one of the unique things, the verb wadda and yawuddu and mawadda never has a romantic or sensual connotation. Whereas the word mahabba, it's very common to have a romantic connotation. But the word mawadda has no romantic connotation. It is a noble love. It is a love where you want to genuinely benefit the other. As well, some of our linguists have said that one of the characteristics of the word mawadda is that you actually want to be with the other person, or you have a desire or yearning to be with that person, either in thought or in proximity. So Allah Azza wa Jal is Al-Wadud. And of the differences between wud and mahabba, our scholars have said, mahabba is what is in the heart, and wud is what is shown in your actions of love. So Allah's love is demonstrated and not just abstract. Whereas mahabba could be in the heart but never demonstrated. So wud, Al-Wadud, is a special type of love, that Allah's love is manifested in action, whereas mahabba is not necessarily manifested in action. And when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the name Al-Wadud has two meanings. The name Al-Wadud has two meanings. Number one, the one who shows love. And number two, the one upon whom love is shown. So number one, the one who shows love. And number two, the one who is beloved. So Allah is Al-Wadud, that He shows love to the creation. And Allah is Al-Wadud, that the creation, or at least the righteous creation, loves Him. And this is an interesting name as well, because there is unfortunately a common misunderstanding, especially amongst some non-Muslims, that the Quranic God is not a God of love. That your God, the God of Muslims, is not a God of love. And this is absolutely incorrect, because of the names of Allah, of the 99 majestic names of Allah, is the name that translates as the loved, the one who loves and the one who is beloved. Al-Wadud, the one who shows love. And Al-Wadud, the one who is the most beloved. So the first meaning, the one who shows love for His servants, this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires good for them. And Ibn al-Qayyim comments that it is not strange for the servant to love the master. It is not strange for any created being to love that which is taking care of it. Because the servant is taken care of by the master, or the animal is taken care of by the owner. That's not strange. What is amazing is when the creator, who has no need of the creation, chooses to love the creation, even though there's no benefit that the creation can give back to the creator. And this is the meaning of Al-Wadud, that Allah loves the creation, even though there's no selfish reason for that love. We love because there's always something coming back to us. We love money, We love comfort, we love water, we love food, we love our children, we love things that will benefit us. There's a selfish element in each and every love. But Allah's love is unselfish. Because Allah doesn't need us, we need Him. Allah created us, we need Him, He does not need us at all. So Al-Wadud is the one who shows love. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the Quran that He created us to show us this love and mercy. This is a Quranic concept that Allah says in the Quran, إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ وَلِذَٰلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. Except those whom Allah has shown mercy to. And to show mercy is why Allah created the creation. So Allah created the creation. The default is that Allah will love and show mercy to the creation. But some of the creation choose to reject that mercy. Some of the creation choose to reject Allah. Some of the creation choose to live sinful lives. That is their business and they will be dealt with accordingly. But the default, وَلِذَٰلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ, I created them for what? To show them rahmah, to show them my beneficence and my generosity. So Allah Azza wa Jal is Al-Wadood, and every single facet of our creation demonstrates this. Our khalq, our entire body, Allah says in the Quran that He is the one who created you and He perfected your creation. Allah fashioned you and He fashioned you in the best of forms. صَوَّرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. We are in the best fashions, the best mold. Allah says in the Quran, don't you look at yourselves? Didn't we give you eyes? أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ. And we gave you a tongue to speak, we gave you this, we gave you that, we gave you intelligence. Allah Azza wa Jal's blessings are mentioned as a manifestation of His love. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the Quran, didn't we create for you the heavens and the earth? Didn't we alternate the night and the day for you so that you can rest in the night and work in the day? So every facet of creation is a manifestation of Allah's love. So much so that Allah says in the Quran that of His blessings, وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ بَنِينَ وَحَفَدًا. He gave you children and grandchildren. And every parent knows the greatest love in our hearts is what? It is the love of our children. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ بَنِينَ وَحَفَدًا وَرَزَقَكُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. He gave you every blessing. So this demonstrates the name of Allah, Al-Wadud, the one who shows love. The second meaning of Al-Wadud was what? The one who is shown love by the creation. So Al-Wadud, the one who shows love. Also Al-Wadud means the one upon whom love is shown. I.e. the object of love, i.e. the beloved. And of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran that, of course, we know this, loving Him is the primary element of worship. Our love for Allah is the most important manifestation of our belief in Him. Allah says in the Quran, there are those who worship false gods and they love them along with loving Allah. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّا لِلَّهِ. Those who love Allah, they love Allah more than those people love their false gods. So loving Allah is a primary concept of believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibn Taymiyyah mentions that the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a unique love. Because only Allah is loved for who He is. Every other object that you love, and I mentioned this before, there is an element of selfishness involved. But Allah Azza wa Jal is loved for His perfection. And love of Allah will never come and hurt and harm us. Ibn Taymiyyah mentions, there is no love that you have for any created object, except that that very love will end up hurting you as well. Now pause here, this is so true. It's so true. Ibn Taymiyyah was an amazing psychologist. Think about it. What hurts the most? It's what you love when it's taken away or when it causes you pain, right? The fact of the matter is, jokes aside, the worst problems come from within the family, right? The most painful problems are spousal problems, children problems, parental problems. Why? Because you love them. And Ibn Taymiyyah mentions there is no love that is a worldly love, except that you will also be stung by that very love. But there is one love that you will never be stung by. And that is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As well, he mentions that every love that you have, if you do not link it with Allah's love, it is going to cause you harm in the long run. Every love that exists must be linked with Allah's love. So you love your children, you link it with the love of Allah. I'm going to be good to my children because that's my responsibility. You love your parents, you link it to love of Allah. You love money, so you link it to the love of Allah. I will only earn halal money and spend it on that which Allah wants me to spend it. And I'll be generous with my money. And on and on. So Allah is the one who is the most beloved. And to show love to Allah means to obey His commandments and to praise Him. Now, the name Al-Wadud occurs with two other names in the Quran. It occurs twice in the Quran, only twice. And the first time it occurs, it occurs with the name Rahim. Rahimun Wadud. Allah is merciful. We talked about Rahim a few days ago. So Allah says, I am Rahim. I show you Rahmah. I show you mercy. And Allah says He is Wadud. So He is loving and He is merciful. And the two obviously correlate. Because the one who loves shows mercy. The one who is merciful shows love. And the second pairing that occurs with the name Wadud is Al-Ghafoor. إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ وَهُوَ غَفُورُ الْوَدُودُ. He is the one who forgives and He's the loving. And we mentioned the name Al-Ghafoor 2 days ago. So Allah Azza wa Jal links the name Wadood to the name of forgiveness. And this demonstrates for us, when should we use the name Al-Wadood? Number one, when we need some blessing from Allah. Wadood, Rahimun Wadood. When we want Allah's Rahmah. So we need a job, we are tired or hungry, we're sick. We can use the name, Ya Wadood, we need your help. You're the one who shows love. And number two, for forgiveness. For forgiveness. When we need to be forgiven, we raise our hands and we ask Allah, Ya Wadood, Ya Ghafoor, forgive us. As well, of the manifestations of Allah's wood, is that He has placed love in our hearts for other creatures. This wood that we have, it comes from up there. Because Allah is the Wadood, so He places wood in my heart and your heart. If Allah was not Al-Wadood, we would not have this love. Where does this love come from? It comes from Al-Wadood. And Allah mentions this in the Quran explicitly in multiple times. For example, when it comes to spouses, and the spousal love is a very special love. What does Allah say? Of His miracles is that He has created for you spouses from amongst yourselves. And He has placed between you two, what words are used? Mawaddatan wa rahmah. Allah, who is the Wadood, has placed that mawadda in the hearts of the spouses. And that is the miracle of marriage. Otherwise marriage would never last. It would not last. But Allah, the Wadood, has placed the wood of the two parties between each other. And the wood also exists between the family members. In another verse in the Quran, قُلْ لَا أَسَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا مَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. Some ulama have interpreted مَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى, that Allah is asking us to have wood for our family members. And of course the famous verse in the Quran, that it was the miracle of Allah that those two parties became brothers together. لَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. This is about something in the seerah, about the groups that were having a friction between them. Allah brought their hearts together. And Allah says, if you were to spend all the money in the world, you would not have brought about that camaraderie between them. But Allah, who is the Wadood, Allah is the one who brought that camaraderie and love between them. So final point, brothers and sisters, how then do we get to love Allah? How do we increase that love of Allah? Number one, studying Allah's names and attributes. And inshallah already, even though only a few lessons have gone by, I hope that every one of us, our love for Allah has increased simply hearing His names. So number one, we increase our love of Allah by studying His names and attributes. Number two, we increase our love of Allah by loving His Rasul. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Explicit. Say, if you love Allah, follow me, Allah will love you. So by reading about the Prophet ﷺ, by loving the Prophet ﷺ, by following the Prophet ﷺ, we will increase our love for him. Number three, a love of good deeds. A love of good deeds. Reading Quran, dhikr, charity, sponsoring orphans. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدَّ. Those who believe and do good deeds, Allah will bless them with wood, with love. Wudud. What does this mean? Allah will give them wood. Our scholars say, those who believe and do good deeds, Allah will love them. And the angels will love them, and mankind will love them. The love that we have for particular people, especially the righteous, Especially, and I gave the example of a person who passed away last week, Muhammad Ali, and we hope that he is in the highest place in Jannah. Where did that love come from? How did so many people love him? Inshallah, we hope and we pray that love is a sign of divine love. Those who believe and do good deeds, Allah will write for them love. سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَانُ وُدَّ So by doing good deeds, we will increase our love. And the final point that we'll mention of increasing our love, literally, we raise our hands up to Allah and we ask Him, like the Prophet ﷺ did, اللهم إني أسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقربنا إلى حبك Oh Allah, I ask for your love. We ask Allah. We ask Allah, Oh Allah, I ask you for your love. اللهم إني أسألك حبك وحب من يحبك and the love of those who love you. All those who love you, I want their love and I want them to love me. And I want to love the good deeds that bring me closer to your love. What a beautiful dua. Let's memorize it. اللهم إني أسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقربنا إلى حبك May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us His love. May He place in our hearts a love for Him and a love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we will continue tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.